Hello everyone. In our last class, we already studied the construction of single phase wattmeter. Now we will today construction of single phase wattmeter, and today we will understand the working principle of the single phase wattmeter. Now let us concentrate. The construction is clear. We are able to measure the load current. We are able to measure the supply as well as the resistance of the coil circuit. Now, let V is the supply voltage, I is the load current, and R is the resistance of the moving coil circuit. Now, current through the fixed coil IF is equals to I, and the current through the moving coil IM equals to V by R. So, the deflecting torque, you can easily say, that is TD divides IF into IM, which is varies to IV by R. Okay, this is the deflecting torque, which is proportional to the IF and IM. So for a DC circuit, the deflecting torque is thus proportional to the power. Always you know, the instantaneous power is given by P is equal to VI. For any circuit, the fluctuating torque, the instantaneous torque is proportional to instantaneous power. In this case, due to inertia of moving parts, the deflection will be proportional to the average power. For sinusoidal alternating quantities, the average power is VI cos phi, where V is the RMS value of the voltage, I is the average value of the current, and phi is the phase angle between the voltage and current. So directly we can say the deflecting torque, which is proportional to the current, that is field current and moving current. We can be able to measure the power, that is the, to be mentioned, it is the especially the instantaneous power of the circuit or the load. Now the advantages. They can be used for both to measure AC as well as DC quantities, as scale is calibrated for both. Now the scale is uniform up to certain limit. It provides high degree of accuracy. It is free from hysteresis and eddy current loss. So the main advantage here, that is we can measure AC as well as DC quantity of the circuit, and it has a high accuracy level, as well as most importantly, it has a uniform scale, which we can get in a short question, that is the scale is uniform for the case of wattmeter. Okay, so we are completing the single phase wattmeter. Clear? Just have a small recap, that is fixed coil, these two, which is help to measure the current for the load, and the moving coil in between the fixed coil, which is help to measure the voltage, so that we can measure the instantaneous power P is equal to VI, or P is equal to VI cos phi. Okay, so this is the end of single phase wattmeter. Now the second part is three phase wattmeter. Again, we are having the dynamometer type wattmeter here, or the three phase wattmeter. It is nothing but the simple construction we are having. A dynamometer type three phase wattmeter is nothing but if we are connecting two wattmeters in three phase load, it will same as three phase wattmeter. A dynamometer type three phase wattmeter consists of two separate wattmeter movements mounted together in one case with two moving coil mounted on a same spindle. So
So there are two current coils and two pressure coil. You can see in the diagram, if we see, this is the first part and this is the second part. If this is for the first two single phase wattmeters are connected on a same spindle, then it will have two current coil, and this in between two are the two pressure coil. Okay. A current coil together with its pressure coil known as an element. So this has two elements, pressure coil, two pressure coil elements and two current coil elements. The connection of two elements are same as the two wattmeter method. See here, we can see that the current coil are connected to load and the pressure coil joined together and connected with the third phase. Okay, that is the connection diagram of the three phase wattmeter. The total torque deflecting the moving system is the sum of the deflecting torque of the two elements. That is, the deflecting torque of the element 1 varies. P1, that is the power consumed for the first leg. If we are having RYB, then if we are considering the first phase, power varies P1. The second phase, power varies P2. Then the total deflecting torque will be the summation of P1 plus P2. Hence, the total deflecting torque of the moving system is proportional to the total power consumed by the three-phase system. That is very important. We are connecting the wattmeters for the first phase, for the second phase. We are just adding up the two wattmeters method. Similarly, like the two wattmeter method, we are adding up the power for the first circuit P1, then the power for the second circuit P2, and again adding up both, we are getting the power of the two circuits, that is P1 plus P2. Hence, the total deflecting torque of the moving system is directly proportional to the total power of the circuit. Okay. Now, in order to measure power correctly, there should not be any mutual interface between the two elements. To compensate the mutual effects arrangement shown in the figure, where resistance R may be adjusted to compensate the error caused by the mutual interface. We can adjust the error here, that is R. If we adjust this error, want to adjust the error, we can adjust the resistance value. Okay, this is very important. If there is any mutual interference, we need to adjust the increase the value of the resistance R dash so that we can compensate the mutual interference. That is the construction and working of three phase wattmeter. Now the last part of the three phase wattmeter is the multiplying factor of the wattmeter. That is, the multiplying factor of a wattmeter is defined as the ratio of product of the voltage range and the current range, that is the full scale voltage and the full scale deflection of it. Okay, is the multiplying factor. Suppose if we are having a 500 watt wattmeter, so the full scale deflection is 500, and at that same time if we have measuring the 100 watt, suppose we are having the voltage of 100 volt and we are having the current of 1 ampere. That is, the multiplying factor will be there. That is, the voltage into current divided by the full scale deflection. You can obtain the correct power of the load by the multiplying factor. Okay. But the already we have performed the lab experiment where we need to, after measuring the power, which is shown in the wattmeter. First of all, we are connecting the wattmeter in the circuit. The wattmeter is showing a value. That value needs to multiply with the multiplying factor to get the actual power obtained by the circuit. Okay. So, for today's theory, we have completed the various power, that is active power, reactive power, apparent power, the definitions, power triangle, then the construction of single phase wattmeter, similarly the construction and working of three phase wattmeter, and the last and but not least is the multiplying factor of the wattmeter. Okay, do study. Thank you.